Chacon, and I'm a student here at Life Pacific College, and I also recorded the song Holy Known. Today we're going to be talking about the history and the story behind Holy Known.
Hi, I'm Stephen Felix Yeager. I'm the chair of Worship Arts and Media at Life Pacific, and I'm one of the co-writers for this song with Mimi and my friend Andy. And so we'll talk a little bit about how this song came about and what it means, and then what it means for Mimi when she wrote her part two. This song was something I was going through when I was, not personally, I was talking to a friend and I was kind of counseling him through a really rough part of his life. And he had a lot of issues of him finding his own identity with God, like who he is in, with God. Like he's grown up in the church and he's known all of that, but every part of his life was always kind of covered with shame and covered with like God is unhappy with him for whatever actions, for whatever he did, for lifestyle and things like that. And so we were talking through it, and he was never angry at God. He was never, you know, trying to be against the church or anything like that, but he didn't know how he fit in that. And so I remember one day he was just telling me this stuff, and I was like, and I just kind of was taken back. He was just telling me all of his stuff. He's like, yeah, I think this, I think God's thinking this and this and that. Mm-hmm. And then I just kind of sat back and I was like, you know, God loves you. And I literally just said those words, God loves you. And just kind of like left it at that, and he immediately started crying. He immediately just kind of like broke down, and in the mess of him finding his faith, he forgot that fact that God loves him.
Yeah.
And that's something I think that was so crucial. It hit me so hard. I have a doctorate in theology. Like, I love thinking about God, and I love doing my work and theorizing and everything. But at the same time, we can allow even that, you know, even like we love the Bible and we read it, we can allow it to make us lose sight of the first thing. The first thing is God himself, God loving us in a relationship. And so I really wanted to write a song, and that was kind of like this key phrase in that song. I want to know you, not what somebody said about you. Reveal yourself to me. And I think that's kind of the heart of the song, is knowing God in truth, like knowing him theologically, you know, like in everything that we know him in that way. But then also knowing him in grace, knowing him that he loves us even when we struggle, even when we have the issues, no matter what we're going in our life.
Yeah.
And then finally at the end of the song, it actually says, I want to know you wholly. So I want to know your truth, I want to know your grace, and then I want to know you wholly. I wrote this song with my frequent collaborator, Andy Wingate, who's, we're in a group together, Social Architects. We've been in groups together in the past. We even do art together. We've been just like one of my main collaborators. And we wrote it, and it just sounded horrible for a male vocalist. Like, so I wrote the song and it just sounded bad with me singing on it. I was like, man, how is that? And so we just kind of knew right away we should probably get a female to sing on this. And we thought it was a really good opportunity because, you know, I'm here at Life Pacific. We were going to put an EP together. So we're thinking, you know, like I can talk to one of the students, and immediately Mimi popped in my head, you know, her vocal style quality, like she's really, really versatile singer, you know, great voice, and was able to kind of, I was like, she's the one. I didn't even think about anybody else. I was just like, maybe we can ask her. And then she was down to do it, and she sang it. We raised the key, and it sounded amazing right off the bat. But then one of the things, whenever you transpose a song, it didn't translate very well, was the bridge.
Yeah.
So I had a part I was already written, and it just didn't sonically flow. And so we just went in the studio, and I was like, hey, Mimi, listen to the song a whole bunch and see what comes from you. And so
yeah.
Mimi wrote the bridge to that, so I want you to kind of talk about that a little bit.
I think one of the things for me that was really important is to really kind of experience that song as my own and to kind of really understand what these words meant.
Mm-hmm.
And I think through that, and I think through sense memory, and I think through feeling and understanding these words and these lyrics, I also was able to say, hey, you know what, this is my life too.
Mm-hmm.
Like, this is where I'm at in life, and I want to understand who God is in my life and who he is now. And I think going through a huge transition in my life, the words new season, new heart just came to mind. And it was just something that was very, just a passionate thing that was stirring in my heart. And I think after reading and hearing those words and the lyrics, I was like, you know what, no. Like, yeah, I'm gonna know you. And yes, I wanna know who you are, not what somebody said about you. And because of this, we're gonna walk in a new season. We're gonna be somebody new together. And so I think that's where that came from. So I think when I first got the offer or when I first got the email, I was very honored because I just, you know, you just have that sense of like, wow, you think I'm important or you think I'm good. Mm-hmm. And so I think I was very honored at the beginning. And I think going through this process of recording the song and the writing of it was very, I could say it was like momentum. It was like the theme of the school. It was like what we had been talking about. And it was just something that I knew that God was calling me into, stepping into becoming a worship artist and kind of stepping up in my calling and my gifting. So I've been also asked by Social Architects to work on other projects. And I think as well as feeling honored and rewarding, it's really cool to see, to be able to work with you outside of school. So we were able to shoot a music video, and I think that experience in itself was really cool. I've never done a music video before, so it was just a really cool experience, and I'm really excited to see just our next project. Let me know your heart. Let me know.